Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the first video of 2022 and the first car show of 2022. Now, I know some of you are going to be a little confused by the fact that I am actually talking to the camera rather than just filming cars and putting music over it. After last year, I did receive some mixed reviews about my video style, so I figured I'd engage in something that I've always kind of talked about doing, but never really committed to. And this year is going to be the year that I finally do it, which is more personal vlog style, me talking to you in front of the camera, behind the camera, all that fun stuff. I've done it a couple times in the past. Those videos have done decently well. So we'll see what happens. I'm going to finish up my coffee. I'm also going to clean off the water on my car because I did the car guy ran dance yesterday. And it rained last night. At least it didn't snow. I can be thankful for that because it is Colorado in that time of year when just random snow can show up out of nowhere. So I'm just not going to acknowledge how much time I just spent cleaning off my car that I had just washed yesterday. Instead, we're gonna go ahead and head on to the car show. On ramps are so much fun. Whee! I love this car so much. So as you can see, the cars have started to arrive after a little bit of time waiting, but gave me time to clean up my car a little bit more, make it a little bit more show acceptable. So yeah, some kind of cool stuff has already shown up. Gonna go and breeze through that real quick and probably go get myself another cup of coffee because I definitely could use it this morning because I'm a little tired. So, I'm not gonna lie, I'm starting to kind of fall in love with these Corvettes. They just look cool, in my opinion, especially the back end. Need to drive one, see what I think of it, but so far, it looks super cool. I know they've been out for a couple years, but still seeing one up here is a little bit more of a rare occasion. Yeah, definitely looking cool here. It's a little crazy for what I thought it was going to be, honestly. I thought that this was going to be a tiny show with not a whole lot here, but yeah, Lotus. Yeah, I'm cool with that.
Left all the rights after the war, and they recondition them. Not to make them.
From the car show, I will say first off, I didn't get as much footage as I would have liked, but that was simply due to the fact that I was involved in really good conversation with a lot of really cool people for a lot of the time that I was there. A lot of questions about Blurberry, which was very cool for me, getting to have genuine cool car guy conversations about my car that I own specifically, which is something that I haven't necessarily been able to do that much in all the cars that I've owned. Maybe with the 300ZX, had quite a few conversations around that, but nobody was really having conversations about the Ford Focus. Well, not good conversations at least. But anyway, that being said, thanks to Northside Kitchen again for having us take up their satellite parking lot, especially on Mother's Day. I was very surprised about that. But it was a really, really good show. I look forward to the next one coming up, hopefully in a couple weeks. And hopefully we don't have another rain incident, so I'm not spending a whole bunch of time cleaning my car that I cleaned the day before again, because I don't want to deal with that. But if you guys like this video, please make sure to like and subscribe. Make sure to also leave a comment, which car was your favorite? There's quite a lot of cool stuff there. Obviously the Lotus, I think that would be my pick on my favorite car. But let me know what you guys enjoyed, what you guys thought. And I'm going to chill out and hopefully Ferrari can come through and win in Miami today. So Forza Ferrari, you guys have a good rest of your day, and I will talk to you all later. Bye.